Children, today we are going to discuss some more chemical properties of metals and non-metals. So today's first reaction is metal with dilute acid. When metals react with dilute acid, there is a formation of respective salt and hydrogen gas is evolved. The characteristic properties of hydrogen gas is it is colorless, odorless gas, it is lighter than air, highly inflammable, as well as it does not dissolve in water, also means it is insoluble in water. The overall reaction depends basically on two factors. First is reactivity of matter, whether the highly reactive matter is taken or matter which is to be taken for reaction is moderately reactive or it is less reactive than hydrogen. Second is acid. We take mineral acid for this reaction, and these mineral acids are hydrochloric acid HCl, sulfuric acid H2SO4 and nitric acid HNO3. So let us try to write down the reaction of these metals with acids. Sodium and potassium. Children, we generally do not allow sodium and potassium to react with acid. The reason is only that when these metals react with water, the reaction is highly exothermic. So if they are allowed to react with acid, then we are not again able to control the heat which is evolved during this reaction. So we avoid reaction of these two metals with acid. It doesn't mean that these metals do not react with acid. They react with acid, but reaction is vigorous and highly exothermic. So we generally do not take these two metals to allow reaction with acid. Now next is we can write the reaction of magnesium with acid. You can take any of the acid out of hydrochloric acid and sulfuric acid, dilute hydrochloric or dilute sulfuric. Again, I want to tell you that you should not react to nitric acid for this reaction. That reason I will explain in the same video later on. So magnesium when reacts with dilute sulfuric acid H2SO4, if there is any question in examination that write down the reaction of metal with acid, then you can take any of the acid until unless particular acid is not being mentioned in the question. So when it reacts, there is a formation of salt. Now children, I am just going to explain one of the trick to write down the product. Actually, this is the confirmatory product, means hydrogen gas is evolved. So we can do one thing. We can just divide acid into two parts. First part which contain hydrogen. So I am just dividing this acid into two parts by drawing this line. Hydrogen and sulfate ions. As this is the fixed product, so I will write hydrogen gas is here. It is gaseous form, so I am just drawing upward arrow. Then what you will do, rest of the part, means rest of the part of this ion, this acid that is negatively charged, and metals are positively charged, means they are electropositive. So what you will do, you will just add this metal with the second half part of acid. Okay, so what will form when metal is added to negative part of this acid, means anion of this acid, we get MgSO4. And what is the name of this compound is magnesium sulfate. Magnesium sulfate will be formed when magnesium reacts with sulfuric acid. So which salt is formed? The name of the salt is magnesium sulfate. Second metal, that is aluminium. When aluminium reacts with, again you can take any of the acids. So now at this time I am taking hydrochloric acid HCl. Okay, when it reacts with hydrochloric acid, again what I will do, I will just separate this acid into two equal parts. Clear? First part cation and second part anion. Metals are electropositive, so I will connect or I will add this metal with the anion, means negatively charged part. Valency of aluminium is 3, so The name of the product is AlCl3 is formed with the evolution of hydrogen gas. Okay, now we need to balance the reaction. 3 hydrogen here, 3 chlorine here. So what I can do, I can write 6 here, 6 HCl plus 2 aluminium. It gives 2 AlCl3 plus 3 H2. So what is the trick to learn these equations? First you need to separate hydrogen, or you need to write down one of the product hydrogen, and rest matter, add matter with anion part means negative part or the second part of acid. These reactions means these tricks you can apply to write down the reaction of matter with mineral acids only. Okay, the name of the product is aluminium chloride. So what is the name of the salt? It is aluminium chloride. Done. Now next is, when zinc granules means small pieces of zinc is allowed to react with sulfuric acid. Okay, why I am writing here dilute? Because the rate of reaction is very vigorous or very high. So when we take dilute acid in which more amount of water is present, it is sufficient to react with matter. Second part, I need to separate, divide acid into two parts. Then one product which I already know or which is confirmed that hydrogen will be evolved, I have written hydrogen here. Add matter with anion part means negative part of the acid, and which salt is formed? That is ZnSO4, zinc sulfate. The reaction is already balanced. So I hope now it would be very easy to learn these reactions, zinc sulfate. Then one more metal we can take, that is iron. When iron reacts with sulfuric acid, you can take any of the acid for practice. When iron reacts with sulfuric acid, again same pattern I follow, divide acid into two parts, add metal with the second part of the acid. There is a formation of ferrous sulfate. When Fe reacts with sulfate ion, there is a formation of ferrous sulfate plus hydrogen gas is evolved. Name of the product is ferrous sulfate because the valency of iron is 2 and sulfate is 2. So it is ferrous sulfate, not ferric sulfate. So these are some of the reactions of metals with acids. Why we don't take sodium and potassium? This I have already explained, that the reaction is highly vigorous. Now just what's about these metals? Whether these metals react with these acids in the same manner? No children. The reason is only that highly reactive matter will react more vigorously, whereas low reactive matter means iron is less reactive out of these 4-1. So the rate of reaction is slow, as well as the reaction temperature means temperature will not rise when iron reacts with sulfuric acid. So on the basis of these 4 reactions, if we want to arrange these metals in decreasing order of reactivity series, so what would be the decreasing order? First is magnesium on the first place, magnesium will come. Then decreasing order, again children, decreasing means first we will write most reactive metal out of these 4, second one aluminium, and third one zinc, and at the last iron. So these are the some of the reactions of highly reactive metals as well as moderately reactive metals. Now come to the next point. What happens when metals which are just below than hydrogen in this reactivity series, when they react with acid? Which acids? Dilute hydrochloric acid and dilute sulfuric acid, nitric acid. We will just talk about it later. When these metals are allowed to react with these acids, they do not able to displace hydrogen from its salt. What are acids? acids are salts of hydrogen, we can say. Okay, so what actually happened in these reactions, these matters, they just displace hydrogen from its salt. It happens. Okay, these matters displaces hydrogen from its salt. But if metal is less reactive than hydrogen, means if they are below than hydrogen in reactivity series, then they are not able to displace hydrogen from its acid. So if I allowed to react with copper plus any of the acid, I am just writing the reaction of copper with acid. Okay, so what will happen? You can take hydrofluoric acid or sulfuric acid. Okay, I'll take hydrofluoric acid. Then what will happen? No reaction will take place. It means it is not able to displace hydrogen from its acid. Same happens with silver, gold and platinum. They do not react with acid in normal conditions. Okay, gold can react with acid when we mix two or more acids, that may be case of aqua regia. So this is all about reaction of matter with acid. On the basis of this reaction, we can arrange matters in reactivity series. So what is the basic criteria of these matters in reactivity series? That when we allow matters to react with oxygen, with water and acid, on the basis of this one, we can arrange matters in a particular order, and that order is called as reactivity series. Children, in the starting of the lecture, I told to you that we generally do not use nitric acid. What is the reason for this one? So now let us explain, or let us try to understand that one. Actually, nitric acid is highly oxidizing agent. What I am telling you, that we should not take nitric acid for the reaction of matter. The reason is only that one, nitric acid is highly oxidizing agent. Highly oxidizing agent. So when metal reacts with nitric acid, because it is highly oxidizing, so it oxidizes matter. It oxidizes metal and it get reduced. It get itself reduced. So which is reduced? The answer would be nitric acid. Which will oxidize in this reaction? The metal will oxidize. Clear? If we talk about this reaction, matter plus nitric acid, then if there is a question that which is oxidized in this reaction, then your answer is metal. And which will reduce in this reaction, then answer is nitric acid. So oxidizing agent here, that is nitric acid. Okay, and reducing agent is metal. So we can connect this reaction with redox reaction also. When it gets oxidized, then there is a formation of nitrogen dioxide, nitrous oxide and any other nitrogen, oxide of nitrogen can be formed. So the product is changed. When metal reacts with nitric acid, in that condition products are changed. There is no formation of salt and hydrogen gas is evolved. That is same. But besides salt, there is a formation of gases. It may be N2O, it may be NO, or any other oxide of nitrogen can be formed. So generally we do not allow, or we do not write reaction of metal with nitric acid. The reason is clear to you, that products are changed. Why the products are changed? Means salt and hydrogen is not formed. And why the products are changed? The reason is clear to you, that nitric acid is highly oxidizing acid. Now if we just talk about this one, that why nitric acid is highly oxidizing agent, means what is special in nitric acid? So let us try to understand the answer of this one, or the query of this one. Nitrogen, okay, its atomic number is 7. Its electronic configuration means if we write EC of nitrogen, that is 2,5, it has 5 electrons in outermost shell, or we can say 5 valence electrons are there. So generally we say that its valency is 3, but its oxidation state is 5. Its oxidation state in nitric acid is 5. How? That we try to understand. 5 valence electrons, that is in one shell, means in 2s, 2 electrons are there. And what are the arrangement of these 2 electrons? In this one, these 3 electrons are left. So I can draw this one, 2px, 2py and 2pz. Okay, so according to the rule, the electrons should be arranged in this manner. So if we see this general structure, the general criteria of this electron configuration, electronic configuration, then valency of nitrogen should be 3. But the structure of nitric acid is like this one, means in nitric acid, nitrogen is present in oxidizing state 5. Now, how these bonds are formed? Actually, due to hybridization, this electron, it shifts here. Okay, so what would be the next configuration of nitrogen? That in this way, 2s remains same, 2px, 2 electrons are arranged, oppositely spin, 2py, only 1 electron, and 2pz, it remains 12. Now we have, nitrogen has 2 lone pair. Nitrogen has 2 lone pair, and with the help of these 2 lone pair, it forms the bond. 2 pair of electrons, it forms the bond with oxygen, 2 bond with each oxygen, and one this bond is formed with OH. So nitrogen is present in 5 oxidation number. So it can make 5 bonds at a time. This is the reason that nitric acid is highly oxidizing agent. Children, this question generally comes in board examination, that when metal reacts with nitric acid, why the products are changed? The answer is only one word answer, that nitric acid is highly oxidizing agent. This is the reason it gets reduced and metal gets oxidized. This, and there are various oxides of nitrogen can be formed, such as N2O, NO, NO2. It depends on the nature of metal also. In this chapter, from starting, we have discussed so many exceptions. So now we must have one exception for this reaction also, children. And that exception is 2 metals. And what are these 2 metals? That is magnesium and manganese. These are the 2 metals which reacts when nitric acid forms salt and hydrogen gas. This is the exception of this reaction, that manganese and magnesium, these 2 metals when react with nitric acid, what compounds are formed? There is a formation of salt and hydrogen gas. Okay, so this is the exception of this reaction. I hope this reaction is clear to you now, and you are also able to understand the reason of oxidizing agent, why nitric acid is highly oxidizing agent. So the next reaction is displacement reaction. This reaction we have already discussed in chapter number 1, chemical reactions and equations. Now once again, let us revise this reaction. Displacement reaction means when high reactive metal reacts with salt solution of less reactive metals, it displaces metal from its salt. Okay, so I am writing the definition of this reaction. When high reactive metal reacts with salt solution of less reactive metal, then it displaces less reactive matter from its salt. Okay, here the salt solution. Salt solution is that solution must be dissolved in water. In dry state, displacement reaction cannot be possible. Children, in your 10th board class syllabus, there are four metals. First is aluminium, second is zinc, third one is iron, and fourth one is copper. Means displacement reaction, we will study about these four metals. So let us take all these metals first. For example, we will take sulfate solution of each metal. So aluminium sulfate, the formula of aluminium sulfate is Al2SO4 whole thrice, first salt solution. Second one is zinc sulfate, ZnSO4. Third one is iron sulfate, FeSO4. And then copper sulfate, CuSO4. Okay, four salt solutions of four these metals. I'm writing here aqueous because this reaction takes place only in aqueous solution. So I'm writing Aq here. Now in the second one, I need to write all these four metals because we need to discuss displacement reaction. So I'll explain this reaction in a tabular form, so it would be very easy for you. First matter, we will take aluminium, zinc, iron and copper. Okay, now I'll just complete this table by drawing columns and rows. Okay, it's done. Now what you need to do, you need to compare only reactivity series. Okay, reactivity of metals, first point. Second point, if high reactive metal is alone, only that it can able to displace metal from its salt. I'm explaining one of the reaction. For example, what happens when zinc reacts with, I'm just erasing these ones so it would be easy to understand you. When zinc reacts with, okay, zinc reacts with aluminium sulfate. Clear? Al2SO4 whole thrice. Aqueous solution. What would happen? Now what you will do, you need to compare the reactivity of zinc and aluminium because only two metals are given to you. Okay? Now, if this is more reactive, then it would be able to displace. Listen the condition carefully. If this metal, means which is alone, which is single, if it is more reactive, then it would be able to displace this metal from its salt because it is already present in its family. So it is already strong. Okay. Now compare the reactivity of zinc and aluminium. Zinc is less reactive. It means it is weaker than aluminium. So what would happen? You will write no reaction takes place. What you will write? No reaction takes place. Clear? Now, just reverse the reaction and try to understand it again. If we allow aluminium to react with zinc sulfate, ZnSO4, again two metals, same two metals are present, aluminium and zinc. Now, what is my second condition? That if this metal is more reactive than this one, then it would displace. So here, aluminium is more reactive than zinc. Aluminium is more reactive than zinc. I can write aluminium is more reactive than zinc. So what would happen? It will displace from zinc. It will displace zinc from its salt. So it will come out. One product, it is already decided that zinc will separate. Al and SO4, electropositive, negative part. Al2SO4 whole thrice will be formed. I hope it is clear to you children that two metals are present in these reactions, and you need to determine that which one is more reactive. Which one means, if the alone metal which is present alone, if it is more reactive, then reaction takes place. If it is less reactive, then reaction will not take place. And what you will write? You will write no reaction. That's it. So now let us try to write down the reaction product of these reaction. First one, what happens when aluminium reacts with aluminium sulfate? Aluminium is alone. You need to compare the reactivity of only this one. These are two aluminium, so they are of same reactivity. Clear? So what will happen? We can write no reaction takes place. There is no change observed in the color of aqueous solution of aluminium sulfate. Second one is aluminium with zinc. Which one is more reactive? Aluminium is more reactive. Okay? So it will displace zinc from its solution. And what product is formed? Al2SO4 whole thrice plus hydrogen gas. Very simple. Sorry, not hydrogen, that is zinc. Zinc is formed. Next one, when we react aluminium with iron, again aluminium is more reactive, as you can see from the reactivity series. So same product, Al2SO4 whole thrice will be formed, plus which metal will be separate out? Now this time iron will be separate out. Again, if we compare aluminium and copper, aluminium is more reactive. So again the same product is formed, that is aluminium sulfate Al2SO4 whole thrice plus copper. One more point children, that these reactions are determined by the color change. Means these reactions are the best example of color change. The basic color of aluminium sulfate is almost colorless. Zinc sulfate, colorless. Iron sulfate, green in color. And copper sulfate is blue colored solution. Okay, so now it is clear, it is of green color, it is of blue color, these two are colorless. Now try to write down second reaction, zinc plus aluminium. When we put some of the pieces of zinc in aluminium sulfate solution, again need to compare the reactivity. Zinc is less reactive, so it is not able to displace aluminium from its salt. So what will happen? No reaction will take place. Simple. Now next is, what happens when zinc reacts with zinc sulfate? Again no reaction, because two metals are same. Next one, when we put some of the zinc pieces in iron sulfate or ferrous sulfate solution, zinc is more reactive in this case. Zinc is more reactive than iron, so it will displace iron from its salt. And what happened? Iron would be displaced, ZnSO4 is formed, that is zinc sulfate. That is zinc sulfate. And all these salts, means aluminium sulfate, zinc sulfate, are found in aqueous state. So what is the physical state of these ones? That is AQ. And these metals will be separate out as a precipitate. You can write solid state or PPT, but better is solid state. Now next is, what happens when zinc is put in copper sulfate solution? Now again, copper just come below hydrogen in the reactivity series, so it will displace, and there is a formation of ZnSO4 plus copper. What is the state of this salt? That is aqueous state. Now next is, what happens when iron is allowed to react with all these salt solution? Again in the same manner, we need to compare reactivity of iron with aluminium. Iron is less reactive than aluminium, so no reaction takes place. Iron is less reactive than zinc, no reaction takes place. Okay, iron with iron sulfate, no reaction. Then iron with copper sulfate. Copper is less reactive, then there is a formation of FeSO4 plus Cu. Children, you need to pause the video and try to write down all these equations. Okay, so hurry up and be quick. The last matter is copper. When copper reacts with aluminium sulfate, now I hope it is more easier to write down the product. Copper is less reactive, it is not able to displace. Copper is less reactive than zinc also, again no reaction. Copper with iron sulfate, no reaction. Copper with copper sulfate, no reaction. So with the help of this table, now we are able to understand that out of these four metals, copper is least reactive. So what would be the reactivity series in decreasing order? First is aluminium, then zinc, then iron, and then copper. This is the first direct question. Second question, which metal is not able to displace any of the metal from its salt? The answer is copper. Next one, which metal is able to displace metals from all these salt solution, means zinc, iron and copper? Answer is aluminium, because aluminium is most reactive out of these four metals. So children, this type of questions you will find on this displacement reaction. Either these questions may include color change. If color change, then reaction takes place. If there is no color change observed, then no reaction takes place. Or even you can find MCQs, assertion reason questions on this, on the basis of displacement reaction. What is the definition of displacement? High reactive matter reacts with salt solution. It should be in the form of salt. Of less reactive matter, then it displaces less reactive matter from its salt. Okay, so this is all about chemical properties of metals. Children, we have discussed metal with oxygen, metallic oxides are formed. Metal plus water, metal hydroxide or metal oxide is formed. And metal plus acid, salt plus hydrogen. And the last reaction is displacement reaction. So I hope these reactions, the chemical properties of metals, is clear to you. When we talk about non-metals, non-metals when react with oxygen, it forms non-metallic oxide. So we will discuss the properties, chemical properties of non-metals also. Okay. First is non-metal plus oxygen. So what is formed? That is non-metallic oxide is formed. Non-metal plus oxygen, there is a formation of non-metallic oxide. Clear? Example, carbon plus oxygen. When we burn carbon in the presence of air, there is a formation of carbon dioxide gas. Sulfur plus oxygen, sulfur dioxide is formed. These are non-metallic oxides, and non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature. Carbon dioxide is neutral, okay? It is acidic in nature. It means they turn blue litmus paper, means their aqueous solution turn blue litmus paper to red. Clear? Second property of non-metal, that non-metals do not react with water. Okay, so non-metal plus water, no reaction will take place. Third one is non-metal plus acid. Again, no reaction will take place. Okay, and the fourth property, non-metal plus salt of another non-metal, means we are talking about displacement reaction. Only few non-metals, they show displacement reaction, and for this one we have reactivity series of non-metals, especially with halogens. And this reactivity series is fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine. Okay, if we talk about reactivity series of non-metals, then we consider only some of the non-metals and these non-metals are fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine. Clear? This is the reactivity series in decreasing order. So just write down some of the reaction. Non-metal, one non-metal we can take, that is bromine plus, okay, Br2 plus 2Ki. Clear? If we compare the reactivity of bromine and iodine, then iodine is less reactive, so it will displace iodine from its salt. Clear? Same we need to follow, and there is a formation of 2KBr, potassium bromide plus iodine will be separate out. Displacement reaction, only a few non-metals show displacement reaction, and one of the example of these are halogens, fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine. This is one of the example of displacement reaction which is shown by non-metals. Non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature. They turn their aqueous solution turn blue litmus paper to red. Non-metal with water, non-metal with acid, generally they do not react with this one. So this is all about chemical properties of metals and non-metals. In our next video, children, we will discuss about the reaction of metal with non-metal, means formation of ionic compound.